Do you think with some of these future things and the speed and the rate it's going, it could bring a new form of DNA-based human beings?
So
something crazy happens. We've got to make this live later.
So to me, the heart of what you're asking, I think, is, are we rebuilding humanity, right? And I can tell you that we're rebuilding everything. We're rebuilding, and why? Why are we rebuilding everything? I mean, why would you rebuild everything? The only reason you would rebuild something is if the original thing were broken, failure, right? So like, if you look at the systems that we have, look at the political systems that we have today. It's messy, right? If you look at the economic systems that we have today, it's messy. Today is a world of the 1% and the 99%, right? And what the 1% are doing is they're performing extraction on the 99%, right? It's extraction. I think Bob's answer was one of the ones I got excited about. I got excited because he was saying, well, it's really more that the people are choosing the companies rather than companies choosing the people. To me, the reason why I think this is possible, right? Because I think what we've had is we've had a lot of cleanies, right? They're all cleanies. They're saying, like, well, here's what's going to happen. It's going to be great. Right? And you could look at thinking that it's marketing for blockchain, right? But for me, the question is, what are the reasons to believe? Like, why should we believe any of the claims, right? So for me, I think the thing that I think we need to understand first is, what is blockchain? And I would like to claim this. I'd like to claim that blockchain is a unique history recording device. And that the history that the blockchain records is the first ever consensus history recording device, right? So instead of having a top-down history that's imposed on what happened, right? Someone's telling us what happened. It's like nobody is telling us what happened. What is happening is what we create and what we do, right? So we take the actions, and the history is we are the ones doing the action, right? And whatever the action that we commit is history. Right? Nobody is inventing a history and putting it on top of us, right? So this is the reason to believe, because our institutions, our infrastructure, my way of reasoning about this is that we are rebuilding everything. And I think we are rebuilding the internet, right? And I think the internet has been full of fake news and fake users and fake everything. And we'd like to rebuild an internet where things are true, right? And actually, you said a very, very important word, which was the word inclusion. I just wanted to throw another word on top, which is consent, right? And the reason why I'm so interested in consent is that for the past 25 to 30 years or so, I've been participating in open source. And open source, actually, when you look at the incentives behind why people participate in open source, there's actually very little, like, primary economic incentive. So really, it's really focused on generating, build our infrastructure to support a new society. It will be a society based on consent. And I think that's something that extraction is not providing today.
Thank you. Thank you.